let's draw a diagram so that we can better visualize what's going on. Here's mu, which is 7.47, and we want to know if the new population parameter will be significantly different. We decide it's significantly different if it falls in the critical region. Remember that the z-score here for an alpha level of 0.05 is 1.96 and negative 1.96. Where does the real population mean fall in the distribution of sample means? Remember that the standard deviation of this distribution is the population standard deviation divided by the square root of n. So the z-score of 7.8 is 7.8 minus 7.47 divided by 2.41 divided by the square root of 30. This is about 0.75. Since 0.75 is less than this z-critical value, but greater than this z-critical value, the true population mean does not fall in the critical region. But we don't know this. We base our decision off of our sample. If we find the z-score of our sample, we do the same thing that we did here, but instead 8.3 minus 7.47 divided by 2.41 over root 30. This is about 1.89. Therefore, our sample statistic also falls outside the critical region. Based on the results of this sample, we would fail to reject the null. And in this case, we made the right decision because this population parameter also falls outside the critical region, close enough to the current population mean. Since we retained the null when the null was true, then this quadrant represents what happened.